Assalamualaikum everyone. Okay, today we will have a webinar from Faculty of Engineering and Built Environment. Okay, so our guest today is Dr. Nabila Rufin from Department of Electrical Engineering. Okay, so how are you, Dr. Nabila? Okay for today?
I'm good. Thank you. How about you?
Alhamdulillah, I'm okay.
Alhamdulillah.
Okay, without wasting our time, okay, I will share a little bit brief about Dr. Nabila Rufin. So Dr. Nabila Rufin obtained her PhD in Electrical Engineering from University of Technology Maharaja Alam in 2018. She started her career as a postdoctoral researcher at University Tunku Abdul Rahman right after completing her PhD. And her research area is on the RFID tag, and she is currently a lecturer in the Department of Electrical and Electrical Engineering, Faculty of Engineering and Built Environment, Masa University. She has published several international and national papers in academic journals and conference proceedings. So today she will give share her knowledge about the radio frequency identification RFID tag antenna. So without wasting our time, let's invite Dr. Nabila Rufin for her sharing knowledge. Okay, so Dr. Nabila Rufin, the floor is yours.
Thank you, TS Dr. Nur Atika Ramlan. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and good afternoon everyone. Okay, I would like to share about RFID today. Before that, let me share to you my screen. Can you see my screen, Dr. Atika?
Oh yes, you can see clearly.
All right, thank you. Okay, RFID, radio frequency identification, is widely known nowadays. It's widely used today. RFID is a technology that uses a radio wave for detecting and tracking an object. By the way, this is my details here. You can contact me through my email here. nabilah.r@masa.edu.my. So let's look at what I will share today. First, we'll start with the definition of RFID. What is actually the radio frequency identifications? Followed by application of RFID. Next is RFID system. Then last but not least, the working principles of RFID. So let's go to the definition of RFID. What is actually RFID? Radio frequency identification is a technology that uses electromagnetic fields to automatically track the tags which attach to the objects. In other words, it is a wireless transfer of data to or from electronic tags that attach to items or objects. The items or object might be your vehicle or car, which is used for electronic toll collection. The object also can be inventory in a warehouse. The tag also can be attached to the books in the library. And it also can be attached to the smart cards for the access control and also for personal tracking. And last but not least, for the animal tagging. Okay, the object might be animal for us to detect and tag the animal. And the tags can be tracked even when they are several feet away and are not within direct line of sight of the radio antenna. It is most likely similar to the barcode, but a barcode needs to be in direct line of sight with the reader, whereas the RFID tags no need to be in direct line of sight with the reader. It needs just to be in the range area of the reader so that the objects can be detected. So there are two main components of RFID system. Firstly is RFID reader, and second is RFID tag. Okay, RFID reader is a combination of a radio frequency module with antenna. It generates high frequency electromagnetic wave, which transmits signal to the tag antenna. Whereas RFID tags can be categorized into three components. Firstly is active tag, semi-passive tag, and last is passive tag. The difference between these three tags is by the power. Okay, active tag is powered by the battery, where it consists of battery to turn on the tech antenna. And because of the battery, it can provide very long distance. And the semi-passive tag, it is powered also by the battery, but it still reflects the radio signal to communicate its information to the reader. While the passive tag doesn't have any battery, it's powered by a radio signal, where the tag reflects radio signals to communicate its identification to the reader. Okay, now let's focus on the passive RFID tag antenna. Passive tag is cheaper and smaller because it doesn't have any battery. As I mentioned earlier, passive only receive the energy from the reader. It doesn't contain any battery. That's why we call it as a passive. It draws a power from the reader, energizes the circuits, and then transmits the information back to the reader. As you can see here in the picture here, we have antenna connected to the reader. We call it as reader antenna, which it transmits signal to the RFID tag, and the tag will receive the signal to power up the chip, then it sends back the signal to the reader. An RFID tag, in its most simplistic form, is comprised of two parts. Firstly is microchip, which is to store the text identification and any other information. And second is a antenna, which is used to transmit and receive the signal. Okay. Now, the tag contains a microchip that stores and processes information. As you can see here, this is the picture of a tag antenna. It consists of antenna in a coil, and also this very small chip, we call it as a microchip. And the chip stores and processes information, while this antenna, it receives the signals from the reader and transmit back the signal. To read the information encoded on a tag, so the tag is placed in close proximity to the reader, meaning that it placed in the read range of the reader, but it doesn't have to be within direct line of sight of the reader. A reader generates an electromagnetic field which causes electrons to move to the text antenna and subsequently power the chip. And the powered chip inside the text then responds by sending its stored information back to the reader in the form of of another radio signal, where we call this as a backscatter, because it sends back the received signal from the reader. RFID tag selection is perhaps the most critical component of a successful RFID system, and hundreds of tag variations are available on the market today. Okay, the size of the passive tag antenna can be as small as a key tag or glass tube tag, as shown in this picture here. Key tag is normally used for the access control so that we can access a building. For example, office, a university, college, or any other building. And glass tube tag normally is used for implantation for animal. It will be implanted on the animal for the detect animal identification. And also the label, RFID plastic label, as you familiar, quite familiar, we are quite familiar with this label sticker. This RFID tag is attached on the windshield or headlamp of the car for the electronic toll collection. And also we have ear tag for the animal tagging, pocket tag for the access control, and paper tag normally for the smart cards, like a credit card. Okay, now let's move to the working principle of radio frequency identification. As I mentioned earlier, we have two main components in RFID system, which is reader and tag. Reader is connected to the computer and also to the antenna. We call it as antenna reader. Okay, the reader is two-way transmitter receiver reader, which communicates with the tag by using antenna. It will use antenna to transmit a signal to the tag antenna. And the tag, as I mentioned, consists of microchip and antenna, where the microchip is used to store and process the information, while antenna is to receive and transmit the radio frequency waves. So the signal given transmitted by the reader will activate the tag, and the tag will sense the data by radio wave back to the reader. We call it as a backscatter wave. And let's see the operating frequency range for the RFID tag. RFID tag antenna can be categorized according to the frequency band. We have three frequency band for the RFID, which is low frequency, high frequency, and also high ultra high frequency. For low frequency, the frequency is between 120 and 140 kilohertz, while high frequency is specific at 13.56 megahertz, and ultra high frequency is from 860 megahertz until 960 megahertz. Difference between these three frequencies are on the read range. The low frequency provide shortest read range up to 10 centimeter only, while high frequency can provide read range up to 1 meter, and the long read range is provided by ultra high frequency radio frequency identification tag, where it can goes up to 10 to 15 meter. Ultra high frequency is very easy to produce, a low cost because the size is smaller compared to low frequency and high frequency, and it can provide high transfer rate compared to these two frequency band. And low frequency normally used for animal identification. As you can see here, this is the example of the tag antenna operate in a low frequency band for animal tagging implantation, and high frequency normally used for NFC, near field communications, smart cards, tickets, and etc. This is the example of the tag antenna used for high frequency. And ultra high frequency is used in many applications such as library, warehouse, personal tracking, asset tracking, electronic toll collection, and any other applications. So now, this is the last slide, I think. Okay, let's see the frequency regulations that has been allocated by ITUT around the globe. For RFID frequency band, each country is allocated different frequency range. So if you want to design RFID tag to be used in Malaysia, you need to design at a specific frequency. For example, let's see Malaysia. Malaysia is allocated the frequency from 919 until 920 megahertz. While our neighbor here, for example, Thailand, the frequency band is from 920 until 925 megahertz. And our next neighbor is Singapore, from 920 until 925 megahertz, and 866 until 869 megahertz. And let's see far away from our country, let's say Europe. Europe is from 865 to 867 megahertz. Okay, meaning that if you want to design tech antenna, to be attached on the car for Malaysia, you need to design within this specific frequency. Let's say the operating frequency is 920, so it is still can be used from Malaysia. If your operating frequency is 924 megahertz, so it cannot be used within Malaysia. You can use that for Singapore. Okay, and if your tech antenna operate below than 900 megahertz, you can use it for other countries such as Europe, okay, and any other Iran and any other countries. All right, with that, thank you so much. That's all from my sharing today. If you have any inquiries or you want to know more about RFID, just email to me to my email nabilah.r@mahsa.edu.my. Thank you so much, and I think I'll pass back to the moderator, T.S. Nur Atika.
All right.
Atika.
Thank you, Dr. Nabila Rizin, for her well explanation, okay, regarding RFID. So I guess everyone already gained a better understanding about the use and application of RFID, as it is also getting famous nowadays, right? Okay, so again, Thank you, Dr. Nadia Arifin, and thank you for all who has kindly joined us for our webinar session today. Okay, so see you next week again on the next session from our faculty. Okay, and then that's all from us. Assalamualaikum and goodbye.